So we back with another video. Y'all seem to enjoy that guard video I dropped for y'all boys. Going over the build that's going to replace 6ix9ine. Today we got y'all boys with a very similar video for a meta lockdown build. Now, I'm done doing the lockdown builds that can only do one thing. I'm trying to make as versatile, as fun builds all around as possible. So, just to make the game as fun as possible, we're going to go with stuff like this. Now, if you guys want me to do the same thing for a big, I can do that. But today we're going to be giving y'all the lockdown build that I believe is going to be replacing all lockdown builds. And I'm not talking about it's going to be the best at being a lockdown. I'm just trying to make a lockdown build that's going to be able to do everything in the game and just be able to have as much fun as possible with that said. So yeah, that's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to go over everything the same way we did with the last one. So we're going to show y'all the build. We're going to show y'all the bad setup. We're going to show you the extra bags I'm going to put on it and even the animation. So if you guys do want these videos, like more videos like this, just go ahead and show the support by liking, comment down below to help the algorithm, subscribe if you're new. Without further ado, though, let's hop into it.
Let's go!
So let's get straight to it. So when it comes to the build, you're going to be shooting guard, handing numbers up to you. Now, when it comes to the build, I feel like there's a little bit more stuff I could have changed on it than the last one. Because the only things I really feel like I could have changed on the last one, I could have got a little bit higher layup on the 6'3". I could have got an 85 vertical to get like the small contact dunks, which I did go over in that video. And it's very simple to do that. But with this one, it's a lot of stuff I could have kind of had more, because maybe I could have went more for a lockdown. Maybe I could have went more for some stuff on offense. But yeah, I feel like I got the best balance of both I possibly could have and still be able to call it a lockdown build. So we're going to be 6'8", 186, and 7'5", wingspan, and body type is up to you. Now, first things first. Now, if you want to change one thing, I would change the strength. I think if you don't feel like you need strength on your lockdown, you're going to be able to get a little bit more, maybe rebound. You're going to get a little bit more interior defense. But I feel like those two things, for the way I'm going to play lockdown with this build, are going to be perfectly fine being what it is. Because I don't need that much rebound, because I'm going to always have a big, so they're going to get rebounds. But if they never need help, I can still go down there with a 66 and a 75 vertical and be able to help that. I've had builds with 66 this year, and they had maybe an 82 vertical. So yeah, I had a higher vertical, so I could get higher on rebounds. But I was doing perfectly fine with just a 66 rebound going against people with 99. So I think I could get it, the job done with this, personally. Now, the 70 strength I put on, if you don't know, I put on because it helps in a lot of situations when it comes to trying to blow by people. But as a lockdown, it's going to help you get way better bumps. It's going to make it a lot harder for you to get blown by. If you use brick wall, it's going to drain more energy. It's going to do a lot of different things that makes it a lot easier to play on ball defense and be a lockdown. So that's why I like having strength on my build. And I said time and time again, my lockdown build with 90 strength was the best pure lockdown build you're going to find when it comes to just playing defense. But we going away from doing stuff like that. We trying to make the build as fun as possible so that you can still be able to dribble, you can still be able to shoot, you can still be able to pass, and you can still be able to dunk. So let's go into it to the top. So we got 13 finishing. I'm going to show you guys how I did the badges. But just know for a fact that out of all the stuff, I made sure to get 4. So if you only have 4, you're going to have to put 4 to finishing and not have anything else plus anywhere else. So yeah, you're going to need the 4 so you can get limitless takeoff and posterizer. You're going to pretty much core posterizer or core limitless takeoff, but it's really hard to core limitless takeoff, so you're going to definitely have to core posterizer, or that's what I do, and then you're going to have limitless takeoff. That's just how I did it. But yeah, you're going to have a 79 layup. You could get an 80, but you have to take a hit, like I said, with strength, and 79 is straight. If you lower that, though, you do lose 2 badges, not just 1, you lose 2. So yeah, I need that 79, but 86 driving dunk to get gold posterizer, not gold posterizer, but gold limitless takeoff and content dunks. So yeah, and you have the 75 vertical to go alongside that. But 75 vertical also does help the block and rebound rating. Now, when it comes to the shooting ability, you do have 85, so you do have the ability to have like silver limitless range, silver agent 3s, which silver agent 3s is a tier 2 badge. So that's a big W, and you do have all these other like gold Hall of Fame badge. Now, I did get a lot of hate on my video for putting guard up in top tier, and I was putting a lot of badges in top tier, but I tested a lot of badges lately, and it seems like just a lot, just because I put a lot of badges in top tier, I'm pretty much just giving 2K credit that they've kind of done really well job, in my honest opinion, of balancing badges. The badges I use and I put top tier, they work really well for me. So maybe they don't work as well for you. I don't know what to really tell you on that. But for me, guard up is a really good badge. But yeah, gold or Hall of Fame, you get these. You do get silver, midi magician, but we're not taking mid ranges. Oh, I'm not. You get Deadeye and Blinded Silver, which are really good badges, and Gold Catch and Shoot, which is a tier 3. Probably not going to be using that. Now, playmaking, you only going to have an 89 ball handle. I say it time and time again. If the 6-8 was able to have a 90 ball handle and the 6-7 got a 92, I'm going to be honest, a lot of stuff will be way different. Like, it will be way less people running 6-9s than 6-8s. Way less people running 6-9s instead of 6-8s or 6-7s. It's just that simple. But since they went off of on both, it makes a big difference. But it does make a difference that the fact that this build does have Hall of Fame, Quick First Step. But it's still not enough for some people to use a 6-8 instead of a 6-9. Well, you can still make just as good of a 6-8 as you can a 6-9. But a lot of that does on next gen have to do with core badges and stuff like that, tiers of badges and stuff like that. But yeah, 75 pass accuracy, that's going to allow you to have the LeBron James pass style. 75 speed with balls going to allow you to have the Michael Jordan dribble style. So two very big things that we get on playmaking that you probably shouldn't be able to have on a lockdown build. And then when it comes to interior defense, I really wanted to get this up a lot more, but 71, we're gonna be able to have for hands up defense. But to make up for it, we do have an 88 block with a 75 vertical. So I did want to get the vertical up more. I tell people all the time, you want to get that vertical up more. It was kind of tough to do that. So yeah, we have a 92 perimeter defense though, so that you can be able to have gold clamp, gold challenger. One thing I did want to do though, I wanted to be able to have Hall of Fame. I've said time and time again, Hall of Fame pick dodger is so much better than gold, silver, or even bronze. But it is just what it is. We just gonna have to have gold. But I may not even run that. I may even just run bronze just so I don't get crazy screened. But yeah, it is a big hit that you didn't be able to get Hall of Fame. But we do have a 95 steal so that you can be able to have interceptor and glove. And a real big deal about the 6-8 being, I think, a comp lock build that you can use that's very versatile is because glove and interceptor are not tier 3s like it would be on a 6-7 or a 6-6. It's tier 2s. Now, one thing I will say, with mismatch expert being kind of more popularized now, and 6-3s and 6-1s being more popularized now, I think 6-8s are going to be kind of tough to make because of that. But there's a lot of factors that make this build a little bit better than the 6-7s and 6-6. I think you can make a really good versatile lock, but I don't know if you can make it as good as this one if you make it 6-7. So yeah, but then when it comes to speed, I do have 80 speed. I feel like that's the minimum you want to have on a lockdown or big man build. 82 acceleration, that's the fastest you're going to be able to speed boost on a 6-8 build. So that's why we don't have more strength. We want to have our acceleration as high as possible to go alongside with a Hall of Fame Quick First Step that you're going to be able to speed boost as fast as possible on a 6-8 build. 70 strength, went over that. 75 vertical, went over that. And 90 stamina, that's just the minimum you want to have. So that's what I do. Takeaways wise, you do end up with the options of Playmaker, Lock, Shark, and Slasher. I really wish we could have Shot Creator instead of Playmaker. But yeah, you can go with a lockdown take. I didn't do it because I don't really need the lockdown badges for the way I play with my lock, because they don't really do too much for me because I'm going to be running gold clamps all the time. But until I get gold clamps, I was running lock take. I just changed my takeovers though. But yeah, I do run finishing moves and limitless range. Now, when it comes to the build, let's show you guys what the name comes out as and the similitudes and all that for video purposes. So yeah, the build comes out as similar to Shades of. Really good options. Mikal Bridges, who has been hooping since he got traded. OG Anunoby, who makes a lot of sense. And Eddie Jones. Those are really good similitudes. And all we gotta do is really show you guys the bad setup, what we added and where we at with the build right now. Now, I will say this, I'm not nearly as far with this build as I am on the last one, because like I said in the last one, I just find myself having to be guard a lot more with the people I play with. But yeah, let's just show you guys the build. Alright, so for where I'm at with the build right now, I'm still in the early stages of grinding on it. But to start off, I tried to make it as balanced as possible. I did the same thing with my 6-3 when I first started out. But I don't have my pass accuracy up yet. I don't have my interior defense up. I don't even have my perimeter defense or steel max. I just got them to certain areas where I can be able to be fine with it off rip. So I maxed out my ball handle and speed with ball so I can do the dribble. But I didn't put up my pass accuracy because I am a lock. I'm not going to have the ball in my hands too much to be passing. But I will be getting that up. I maxed out my 3-ball, my driving dunk. Didn't get my layup yet. Didn't get my mid-range yet. And yeah, that's pretty much mainly the things I didn't get to get up. I didn't get my rebound either yet, but I don't really care too much about rebound starting off because I'm not going to be the main person going for rebounds. But I did get my block, my vertical up. I got my vertical and dunk up so I can get contact dunks though. So if you didn't go vertical on next gen, you wouldn't be able to even have that. I do think you could make this a lot better of a lockdown build if you are on current gen, because you don't have to go too crazy on vertical. But I do think vertical is important when it comes to going for like block and rebound. So at the same time, maybe you do. But yeah, We haven't maxed out the acceleration yet, but we do have the max speed. We do have the max strength. We do have the max stamina. But the acceleration is right there to be in max. So all in all, pretty balanced already. Just a couple things here and there that we need to get up. And we're going to be pretty straight. Like, once I max out the pass accuracy, layup, we're going to be pretty straight. Now, we're going to become even better at being a lockdown when we max out the perimeter defense and steal. But right now, it's been pretty crazy already. Now, when it comes to the badges, I did put +4 to the finishing, like I told y'all. But I have 6. So I did +4 to the finishing, and I can easily tell y'all what I did here because it's obvious. I did 4 to the finishing, and I put the leftover 2 to defensive because, what? It is a lockdown build, and I'm going to need more for the defense. So right now, what I've been running so far, I don't have that many badges earned because I haven't grinded this build nearly as much as I did the other one at this point. But yeah, I'm running Area Wizard so I can catch lives, back down punisher, drop step, which I really have not had the point of. I don't even know why I have that on, I'm gonna be honest. I really need to put this on, and I need to put this on so I don't get blocked. That's really what I should be running. I don't know why I had that on. I've not had a chance to even post nobody up. I don't know why I had that on. But rise up so I can do more standard dunks. Giant Slayer so I don't get blocked, and Acrobat for when I do double clutch layups. It's just that simple. And then, yeah, Area Wizard for catching lives. But what I will be running eventually, I will, like I said, I'm a core Slithery, and then I'm going to have Limitless Takeoff. I'm going to have Area Wizard. So this is going to be 7. I'm going to have Area Wizard. That's going to be 5. And then I'm going to have 4 right here. And I probably will have Rise Up Bronze, or I'll have Acrobat Bronze. It's gonna be one of those. I know I'm gonna have silver here. I'm gonna have gold here, and I'm probably gonna have bronze here, or bronze here. It's gonna be one of those. So yeah, I'm gonna easily have Limitless Takeoff and Posterizer once I get Posterizer Core. So yeah, when it comes to the shooting, this again is gonna be it's definitely gonna be Limitless Range Cord. I'm gonna have Green Machine on. I'm gonna have Agent 3s on, so that's gonna be 9. I'm gonna probably try to have Clutch Shooter. I don't know if I'm gonna have Volume Shooter on this build because I'm not gonna shoot as many threes on this build as I would on my guard. I'm not gonna have Amped. I may have Space Creator, but I have not found myself doing hotbacks nearly as much. If you do use hotbacks, I do advise you using Space Creator. But Claymore I may use, but I move more off the ball. I'm not really much of a spot up. So I'm definitely gonna have Agent 3s, Green Machine, but if I do have the ability to do so, I'll probably run like a Blinders. I'm not gonna lie. I'll probably run like a Blinders, Green Machine, Agent 3s, with Clutch Shooter if I can, with Limitless Range Cord. That's my dream setup if I can get that in 18 badges. Now, when it comes to the playmaker, I have 20. I'm gonna have Quick Wrist Step, I have Vice Grip. That's gonna be the 2 autos. I'm gonna have Unpluckable. That's probably gonna be what I get Cord. I'm probably gonna end up running Clamp Breaker. And then after that, I probably will have to have Needle Threader. I won't be able to have Bailout. So yeah, that's probably what I'll end up running. We'll see when that time comes. But this is what I've been running lately. I need to change this back to this. I do need at least to have Vice Grip on. Maybe not so much, but Vice Grip does get you better catches and stuff like that. Like I said, I'm still in the grinding stages of it. Now, defensive, I did end up adding 2 more. It probably would have been easier to show y'all the bad setup, like in the test build phase, so I can actually show y'all everything that I'm gonna do. But I wouldn't have the 17 finishing, but I couldn't even show y'all the core either way. So I don't know. I probably should have did that, but I am gonna run Chase Down Artist Gold. I'm gonna have Glove and Interceptor both gold. That's both gonna be gold. Both are gonna be gold. I'm gonna go ahead core this right now because I did end up getting this core. But I'm going to definitely probably end up actually coring Clamps. The thing is, after I get that core, I'm going to probably run Challenger. But I'm going to definitely have Glove, Interceptor, Chase Down Artist. After these 3 badges, though, I don't know what I'm running after that. Because this is going to be 5. This is going to be 5. And this is going to be 6. So 5, 5, that's 16. I'm going to have Clamps Cord. So that's 8 more badges I'm going to have. So I could run Challenger and just run one more. Or what I could do, I could run like an off-ball pest. I could run like a pick dodger and a menace. But I think I am going to end up running menace and box out beast for sure. I just don't know for a fact 100% what I'm going to run yet. But I do know for a fact I'm going to run menace. I just don't know 100% what I'm going to run yet. When that time comes, we'll know for a fact what we're going to run. But yeah, that's pretty much what I'm going to be running for sure. Let's go ahead and hop into like the animations. Animations wise, let me show y'all the jump shot I've been using. I think I just showed y'all. This is the jump shot I actually do use on my lock. Tobias Harris, Sadiq Bey, and Clay. This is what I've been using on my lock. I don't really like the Kuzma that much on my lock for spotting up per se, because the timing does change a little too much. Tobias changes, but it doesn't change to the same frequency from my experience. I don't know why I did that, but yeah. When it comes to this, is the free throw I've been running. This is probably the layup I'm gonna probably run the whole time on this build. I'm not gonna lie. Dribble pull up is what I've been running. I tried the Kawhi, didn't like it. Is what I've been running. I just went over kind of all these animations in the swing animations. This is what I've been running for my dribble style. I've been running Tatum, but I think I am gonna go back to running Tracy eventually on this. I have been running Paul George because, like I said, I haven't been doing the hot back nearly as much. Jordan pull is what I run, but if I wanted to, I could run Russell Westbrook. I've been running pro, but somebody said that Scotty is really good, so you could run that as well. I've been running basic. Luka, Michael Jordan. I'm gonna run LeBron on this. That's what it is, but my pass accuracy just not maxed yet. And that's pretty much all the animations for that. Dunks, I will be running on this build. Russell Westbrook automatically. I'm gonna run elite alley-oops because I don't like running pro with elite or Zion. I just want to run Zion and elite or just elite because it just the timing just changed too much when you have pro and one of those other ones. Like I said, contact dunks, I'm gonna put on all the alley-oop contact dunks because you have no way of really determining if you're gonna get that. So I just put on as many as possible. I only get pro though. I only get pro contact dunks, but I do put on the off 2 feet and off 1 foot. I do run quick drops. I don't run front clutches. I'm not really a front clutch guy. When I do have the ability to get two-hand under basket regular, I will be running two-hand under basket regular, and that's pretty much the dunk package I will be running. Is there anything else to really show y'all? This is the stuff I run. So I run like slap floor when I'm in a pro-am or setting, head tapper, three low, big carry. But that's pretty much it. I'm going to be honest. That's pretty much it. Now, when it comes to these videos like this, if you guys want me to do more videos going over like the badges and like the animations all in the video, just make sure y'all leave that in the comments down below if y'all do like these versions of the build videos where I do a dedicated build video and show you guys everything throughout that build. Now, I can't update y'all on this build later when I actually am at the point of grinding it. That's probably what I should have did, but y'all said y'all need that lockdown video. So I gave that to y'all as soon as I possibly could. But yeah, that's going to be the end of this video. If you guys want more, make sure to like the video. Make sure to subscribe if you're new. Turn on notifications. Be the first to all the videos. All that out the way. I've been appreciating all the support y'all been giving me. Keep going crazy. I know 2K has been kind of boring, kind of dead. But y'all been going crazy for me. And I do appreciate it. But yeah, without further ado, man. It's your boy Fitz. And I do it, man. So I was checking my analytics. Even with 100K. We still have 80% of you guys not subscribed. I don't know what else I gotta do. Now, if you guys wanna get more in touch with me, you can join the Discord. But how you watching my videos and not subscribe? Subscribe! It's that simple.
'Em to bring me my money.
Yeah!